What's up guys, Corvus95 here and welcome to another episode of Pokemon Blue. On today's episode we are taking on the Cinnabar Island Gym, but first of all we have a few party changes to make. Now, as you can see, nothing really outstanding, like, that stands out compared to usual. I mean, Faraday is back in the party, and that's for a very good reason. We have some evolutions to take care of. First of all, we're going to do Pura. We're soon to have a Ninetales, and here it goes. And there is our lovely little Ninetales. Next up, we have Faraday. We're not keeping it as a Pikachu, even though I prefer the Pikachu to Raichu. And there is our Raichu. Yeah, I prefer Pikachu to Raichu overall, but Raichu just outclasses Pikachu in every way. We're also going to use this TM. Best TM in the game, probably. Earthquake. And as much as I would love Rosai to have it, he learns it naturally, whereas Cotton does not. Yes. Get rid of Tackle. So I think Cotton's going to be our lead for this gym. Oops, I was pressing the wrong key. And we'll go to Cotton, switch with Lindbergh. And we actually need to go heal up quickly. Because I forgot to heal after the Pokemon Mansion. Now, our strongest Pokemon is Lindbergh, who's level 38. Our weakest is Faraday, who's level 30. And Blaine's weakest Pokemon is level 40. The strongest is level 47. So, quite a gulf in class between our two sets of Pokemon there. Now, this is a question-based thing. Pokemon quiz. Get it right and the door opens to the next room. Get it wrong and face a trainer. If you want to conserve your Pokemon for the gym leader, then get it right. Here we go. Caterpie evolves into Butterfree. Well, it evolves into Metapod and then into Butterfree. I want to face every single trainer here because I do need to get some levels, so I'm going to say yes. Well, it doesn't evolve directly into Butterfree. I thought I was going to say you're wrong. Good, you can still battle the trainers. So Burglar wants to fight. And he has a level 36. That's almost as strong as my strongest Pokemon. And it's the first trainer in the gym. And he has more than one Pokemon. Got EQ. He'll easily one-shot. Best move in the game. Probably, even in Gen 6, it's probably one of the top 5 moves in the game. Along with Scald, Knock Off. I'd say Spore. Vulpix. And we will switch out. No, we'll stay in. I said no, we'll stay in. Yeah, so along with those couple moves, I think it's probably in that top 5. I don't know who else I'd. Or what else I'd put in the top 5. Spore gets in obviously because it's 100% accurate. Probably. I'm not sure. Because it has to be widely distributed, so I suppose Spore shouldn't go in the top 5 because it's not widely distributed. There's like 6 Pokemon that can get it. It's like the Breloom line. Parasect line and Smeargle, and I'm sure there's something else, but that's all I can think of. Can we go? The keyboard for some reason today is being very strange. in terms of I press a direction and it doesn't actually go that direction straight away. So I have a super nerd, which is amazing. It's an amazing title to have. I am the super nerd. Vulpix goes for the quick attack. It's a 2-hit KO. Go for another quick attack. Strange that they wouldn't use Ember. It would probably do just as much, if not more. Probably even, it would do like double that, maybe. Because it's a special attack, so it's hitting off Vulpix's stronger start. Let's switch out here. Let's go into Vallejo. It's hitting off Vulpix's stronger start, and it's got Stab, so yeah, it'll easily do more damage. Let's go for the Surf. Should take it out. And it does. Excellent. And in Ninetales, let's go out into Rossetti for this one. We have three Pokemon that can take out fire types, so I'm not worried about this gym. Go for the dig. And it should be a one shot, I would think. And it is, even without a critical hit. Super Nerd has been defeated. Yow! Hot, hot, hot! Go up. There's actually two trainers here. You have to talk to the left one. Get around, go through the door, yes. Get around, face the trainer. There are 9 certified league badges. No. There's 8. There's never been a region with 9 badges, as far as I know, in the games. No, there hasn't. I mean, even in the second generation games, when there were 16 badges, there was only 8 per region. Something that I thought would always be interesting was if there was something like that, where there was like a shared gym. Sort of how like the Elite Four shared, but there was like one gym that shared. It's like the first gym leader. So you kind of like rematch them, like a grudge match sort of thing. A Charmander. Let's try out Faraday. I don't think Faraday is going to get much screen time, so... Yeah, I forgot it was a Raichu. Still thought it was a Pikachu. Much bigger on the screen than I remember. Let's go for the quick attack. Finish off the Charmander. Excellent. And a Vulpix. Sure, Faraday can stay in since he's our lowest leveled Pokemon. You win quick attack. Thunderbolt will do over half, I'm pretty confident. Does, and a second one will take him out. Okie dokie. A Growlithe. Sure, I'll fight that. Ember. Doesn't do much. And we'll take out the Growlithe. Faraday grows to level 31. We defeat the Super Nerd. His studies, no! So how many more we got? We'll go 1, 2, 3, 4, it looks like. Go around, the door opens. Yes, I know, I know, I know. Poliwag evolves 3 times. No. It evolves once. Doesn't evolve twice. Poliwag evolves once, and then Poliwhirl evolves twice. Well, Mr. Trainer here. It's a burglar. It's quite interesting that an official gym leader uses burglars in his gym. And we'll go for the EQ. I think since I do want to get the gym battle in today's episode, this is going to be the last train I'll face on camera. I'll show you all the traps, but then I'll battle all the trainers and meet you at the gym leader himself. I mean, I may get one of these wrong, because they're not worded the best. Yes, I know. Are Thunder moves effective against ground element type Pokemon? No. Okay, so that's one trainer we'll have to fight. I'm gonna fight him off camera. I'm gonna fight this guy off camera if I get this right. Pokemon of the same kind and level are not identical. Yes. Absolutely correct! Because the IVs going up to 15 in this game make them all different. Plus EVs you can do up to 252 in every star, or 255 in every star. Okay. TM28 contains Tombstoner. Definitely not, that's not a move. Contains Dig, I believe. Okay, so that is Blaine. So, I'm gonna cut off the recording here and I'll be back in a split second for you guys. But in the meantime, I'm gonna battle these remaining three trainers, go heal up the Pokemon, and I'll meet you at Blaine. So I'll see you then, guys. Hello, guys, and welcome back to Blaine's gym, as you can see. Cotton got to level 35. And these top three are going to be the three Pokemon we use in this gym battle. We may actually only need one, but let's get underway. Ha! I am Blaine! I am the leader of Cinnabar Gym! My pirate Pokemon will incinerate all challengers! Ha! You better have burn! You what? Ha! You better have burn heal! I always thought it was you better have packed burn heal. You better have packed burn heal! I prefer that. You better have burn heal just seems very short and snappy. Look at that sprite. He looks like a mad scientist. Which I suppose he is. Okay, Growlithe, level 42. Let's go for the EQ. It'll one-shot. Yay! There's no way it lives. Good, it didn't. I didn't want it proving me wrong. Congruta, 36. Which means that the Ponyta gets to fight Mr. Rossetti. Mr. Rossetti has such little HP compared to every other Pokemon. Let's go for the dig. I dug a hole. Dig hits and takes out the Ponyta. Mr. Rossetti goes to 36. And next up is the Rapidash. So we'll let Philomo take care of this. And with 42? Yeah, 42. And Surf! You tail whipped me. How dare you actually get an attack off? It's not allowed. Go for the Surf. I mean, even though I'm massively underleveled, I have the type advantage, so these balls aren't that hard. Go for the quick attack. Take out the Rapidash. Velamo grows to level 36. And now an Arcanine. That's crazy if I tried to get Pyra to win, isn't it? One may as well. Level 47 Arcanine against a level 35 Ninetales. Let's swap our moves around a bit. Let's go for the Flamethrower. I outspeed, surprisingly. That does very low. What? First turn Super Potion. I don't understand the logic there. Use the Super Potion before I did damage. Oh. Oh. That was a lot of damage. And he took hardly any recoil at all. And he's not confused anymore. We have a speed tag. Roll went before my move, anyway. I always thought Roll went last. Why am I trying to kill an Arcanine with a Ninetales? And why does he only outspeed when he confused. That does such little damage. Well, he did 49, so I won't die to another takedown. Hurt yourself. Good. Thank you. Determined Pura is going to win this battle for me. Come on, Pura. It's almost done. Take down, survive it. Thank you. We take him out with a quick attack, and we have 7 badges. Excellent. 2000 experience, we defeated Blaine.
I have burned out! You have earned the volcano badge!
We gained 4,600 poker dollars and.
Ha! The volcano badge heightens the special abilities of your Pokemon. Here, you can have this too.
I believe this is Fire Blast. Yes, Fire Blast. Teach it to your Fire type Pokemon. Charmeleon or Ponyta would be good bets. Fair enough. I mean, you had a Rapidash, and I doubt anyone's starter hasn't evolved to its final form by the 7th gym. Oh, I suppose my Venusaur, I only got Venusaur on the way to the 7th gym. And it evolves earlier than Lala too. So, we're gonna head to the Pokemon Center, heal up. And then, we are going to head to Viridian City. Because we're almost at Pokemon League. Got one more gym to do. It's amazing how quickly the end of this game goes. But actually, because it's a ground type gym, the final gym, we're gonna have to swap some Pokemon around. We're gonna deposit Lindberg. Yeah. We're also going to deposit Faraday. Because they're the two that can do basically nothing against this gym. And we're going to get out Amethyst and Ruby. Ruby is hopefully going to be the main star of this gym. Oh, I don't have my flyer anymore. We're going to go get Lindberg back out of the VC. I think we're going to swap Lindberg for Pura. Deposit, get rid of Pura, and we will withdraw Lindberg, just for the flying ability. Okay, down here, and then Pokemon fly to Viridian City. And I just healed, didn't I? We'll swap out Ruby for Cotton. Ruby at the front of the party. And we will head to the gym. Up and around. And yeah, that's gonna be where we end this episode, guys. Slightly under the 20 minute mark I strive to aim for every day, but on the next episode we are going to take on the Viridian Gym. I don't know if we'll get the badge, but hopefully it'll be similar to this episode where if we get to the 10 minute mark and we're only like a quarter of the way through the gym or whatever, we will just skip to Giovanni, who is the final gym leader of the Kanto region. And yeah, if you've enjoyed this episode, guys, make sure to leave a like on the video. Make sure to subscribe to the channel as well. And from me, Corvus95, thank you guys so much for watching the video. And goodbye.